What up, YouTube? Welcome back to my channel. My name is Bizmatic, and I'm back with another one for y'all. Look, this time around, it's the truth behind the Lynyrd Skynyrd plane crash. This is a video by Grunge. Shout out to Grunge, man. Y'all be having all the information that I need. I know some of y'all like, don't do these documentary style videos because they be wrong. Well, they not more wrong than me when I don't know anything. But if you're new here, please hit that subscribe button and hit that notification bell. And if you know better than the actual documentary I'm about to watch, this mini doc I'm about to watch, you let me know then. Educate me, because I be wanting to know things. You feel me? I want to know things about these bands that I'm exploring, that I'm finally getting to enjoy, that I'm finally getting to appreciate their art and all that stuff. I want to know. So bring the likes up if y'all want to see and hear more Lynyrd Skynyrd on this channel. Let's watch.
For many, the name Lynyrd Skynyrd instantly conjures up the day in 1977 when three band members died in a plane crash in the woods of Mississippi. For Lynyrd Skynyrd fans, that day was one of the most tragic in rock history. Here's the truth behind the Lynyrd Skynyrd plane crash. On October 20th, 1977, Lynyrd Skynyrd was skyrocketing to fame and had several new members on the start of a three-month tour to promote their new album, Street Survivors. But they weren't exactly traveling in style. The plane chosen for their tour was an old 1948 Convair 240, a twin-engine prop that had already racked up over 29,000 flight hours. It was shaky enough that earlier in the year, Aerosmith had decided the plane was too dangerous to fly in. Still, despite the protests of guitarist Alan Collins and head of security Gene Odom, Lynyrd Skynyrd decided to use it anyway, with bandleader Ronnie Van Zant reportedly saying just before boarding, "If the Lord wants you to die on this plane, when it's your time, it's your time." Damn. It would prove tragically prophetic. The plane took off at 4:02 p.m. from Greenville, South Carolina, heading for Baton Rouge, Louisiana, with an estimated arrival time of 6:45 p.m. Pilot Walter McCreary notified the flight tower that they had roughly 5 hours of fuel on board, plenty for the flight. But just a couple hours later, while still over Mississippi, McCreary contacted the Air Traffic Control Center in Houston, saying they were out of fuel. It was the last communication from the plane. Band members were playing cards while Van Zant napped on the floor when the pilot suddenly alerted them that they were out of fuel. Drummer Artemis Pyle, a pilot himself, told everyone how to prepare for the crash. While some reportedly panicked, most just sat in silent prayer, hoping for a safe landing. 10 minutes later, the plane went down in the trees near Gillsburg, Mississippi. Keyboardist Billy Powell told the Orlando Sentinel, "I remember we started clipping those pine trees. It felt like being rolled down a hill in a garbage can and being hit by about 100 baseball bats at the same time." The plane then impacted the ground and skidded another 140 feet. The wings were torn off and the cockpit smashed into a tree, killing McCreary and his co-pilot, William Gray. The fuselage broke off and the top of the plane tore open, throwing people out. Powell told Rolling Stone, "I crashed into a table. People were hit by flying objects all over the plane." The remains of the plane finally slid to a stop in a swampy, wooded area. Powell crawled out of the wreckage and saw that the fuselage, cockpit, wings, and tail section were gone. His nose, he discovered, was now hanging from the side of his face and bleeding profusely. The musician sat on top of the airplane in shock, crying, before he heard bassist Leon Wilkinson calling for help. "I remember Leon screaming, 'Get me out of here!'" Pyle also survived the crash, his ribs, quote, "sticking out of his chest." Along with roadie Ken Payton, the three left the crash site seeking help. They found it in the form of local farmer Johnny Moat, who originally thought the ragged men were escaped convicts, before realizing the awful truth. He told Rolling Stone, "One of them was hugging me around the neck and telling me, 'We gotta get them out.'" But there was no help for pilots McCreary and Gray, band members Ronnie Van Zant, Steve Gaines, and Cassie Gaines, or assistant road manager Dean Kilpatrick. All six were killed on impact, and the 20 survivors were in bad shape, with Rolling Stone reporting that they endured shattered bones, torn flesh, lengthy hospitalizations, and grueling rehabilitations. Fans were stunned as images of the crash began playing on news reports across the world.
You can't even realize, seeing one of these things on television, exactly what a crash of this magnitude looks like.
Speculation on the cause of the crash immediately centered on the lack of fuel.
Authorities still believe the plane ran out of gas. But why? Didn't they put enough gas in the tanks? Or was there a leak?
After a lengthy investigation, the U.S. National Transportation Safety Board released its official investigation. 9 separate findings were listed, including statements that both engines on the plane, quote, ceased to produce power because the aircraft's usable fuel was exhausted, and that the crew, Walter McCreary and William Gray, quote, failed to monitor adequately the fuel flow, en route fuel consumption, and fuel quantity gauges, and also didn't take appropriate pre-flight action to ensure an adequate fuel supply. But their mistakes were apparently compounded by a mechanical failure that caused one of the engines to burn through fuel much faster than normal. That would explain why, on another flight 2 days earlier, Alan Collins witnessed a 10-foot flame shooting out of the right engine. Ironically, Pyle told the Orlando Sentinel that during the tragic last flight, the band had decided that going forward, they would only fly on new planes. We had decided to get a Learjet for the band, a beautiful bus for the crew. It was ridiculous for us to be on an old plane like that. With the plane crash behind them, it would take time for everyone involved with Lynyrd Skynyrd to recover. 5 surviving band members, Alan Collins, Billy Powell, Gary Rosington, Leon Wilkerson, and Artemis Pyle, suffered critical injuries from multiple broken bones to debilitating internal injuries. It looked like the end of the band forever.
Will there be a Lynyrd Skynyrd after this? I don't think so.
The first step in the recovery process was changing the album cover, which originally showed crash victim Steve Gaines surrounded by fire. But it was a long process, and it wasn't until a decade later, in 1987, that the surviving members of the band reunited.
First thing I want to do is bring out the survivors of our plane crash we had 10 years ago.
The band reformed, joined by a former guitarist for the group, Ed King, with Ronnie Van Zant's brother, Johnny Van Zant, taking over as lead singer. But there would still be more tragedies. Collins, who was left paraplegic after a motorcycle accident in 1986, succumbed to pneumonia in 1990. Wilkinson was found dead in his hotel room in 2001. And in 2009, Powell died of a heart attack. That left Rosington and Pyle as the only surviving members of the original band.
Damn.
In October 2019, Ronnie Van Zant's widow, Judy Van Zant Jenis, joined others to dedicate a new monument at the crash site, created with money from the Lynyrd Skynyrd Monument Project, which raised over $80,000. Van Zant Jenis said, "It's been 42 years today since we lost Ronnie, Steve, Cassie, and Dean. But they will live on through the music of Lynyrd Skynyrd and all of the fans from around the world." And 2020 promises to be a big year for the band. A film about the tragic plane crash called Street Survivors, the true story of the Lynyrd Skynyrd plane crash, is scheduled to be released in June. The same month, Lynyrd Skynyrd is planning to play their final concert ever at the end of their Last of the Street Survivors farewell tour. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more grunge videos about your favorite bands are coming soon. Man, subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss us.
I don't know, man. For tragedy to keep striking in one place so many times, That's weird to me, you feel me? Like, and you know what? They're not the only bands or musicians that this happens to. There's bands and musicians that tragedy just keeps striking in one place, like boom, 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 boom. But that plane crash, man, I hate planes, yo. Stay out of the water and stay out of the sky, right? You were born on land. Stay on land, man. Stay on land. Yo, I don't know. I don't like flying. I don't like going on boats. Shoot. I know how to swim, kind of. Wow, that's tragic, man. Great band, great band. As y'all know, my Lynyrd Skynyrd journey has been very extensive. I've done so many Lynyrd Skynyrd songs, it's crazy. But y'all let me know what Lynyrd Skynyrd songs y'all want to see on this channel next. And y'all let me know if this documentary missed anything in the comment section below. Educate me. If you made it this far, subscribe. For my OG triple OGs, the ones who always watch till the end, go in the description box. I got a second channel. Subscribe to that. Help the brother out. You feel me? Peace. See y'all in the next one. Y'all better be there.